Hi, welcome to Kids Pub. I'm Heather McCullough. Shannon, we're talking about collaborative and proactive solutions. What is that?
So the main idea of collaborative and proactive solutions is that kids do well if they can. And so adults who are practicing the model would know or take challenging behavior as an indicator that there are some lacking skills. And so the process would go about teaching the students how to communicate their concerns, how to take into consideration the concerns of the adult, and then collaborate to come up with some solutions that are mutually satisfactory.
So walk me through what would happen in a collaborative meeting.
So we would have, as an adult team, we would have spent some time figuring out what are the lacking skills for that particular child. And then we would have a conversation with them. So it's called a Plan B conversation. And we would ask the student about their concerns with that particular situation, what's hard about that situation. We would have an opportunity to share our concerns, usually about the safety risks that might be involved with some of the challenging behavior. And then we would work together to try and come up with a solution. And so that's where the students really learn how to come up with adaptive solutions to the challenging behaviors they might be having.
All right, so when we come back, we're going to find out how parents can get involved and how this can actually work at home with any parent and child situation. That's coming up on the Kids Club. Hi, welcome back to Kids Club. I'm Heather McCullough. Shannon, we've been talking about collaborative and proactive solutions to difficult behavioral problems. Do you find often that it's not the behavior itself, but it's what's underlying that leads to that behavior that you uncover?
That's often the case, and so we do typically enter a conversation with a student talking about some difficult situations that they might experience sitting in their chair, for example, or working with a partner. And so typically they surprise us with some of the responses they come as to why that challenging behavior might be happening. So it really is important to get their perspective.
So it's a little bit of detective work, for
Absolutely.
Sure.
Absolutely.
And I'm sure parents can utilize this at home in many situations. How can they find out more information and sort of learn about this approach?
So there's a fantastic website. Dr. Ross Green's website is called livesinthebalance.org. He's also written a book with a parent lens called The Explosive Child. But the basic tenets are the same for whether you're working at school or home.
All right, fantastic. Very important information. Thank you so much. This has been the Kids Club. I'm Heather McCullough. We'll see you again next time.
Kids Club is brought to you by the Boys and Girls Club of Kawartha Lakes, a good place to be. For more information, visit bgckl.com.